Hey everyone, my name is Amantalan. Today I'm talking about my project called RedisAnt. I created this project during Redis Hackathon 2021. RedisAnt is an automatic client-side caching using RedisJSON and MongoDB. It's an end-to-end solution for managing your client-side caching. To understand this, let's take a use case. Let's say you're trying to create a notification service and you want to keep your device ID for each user in your local cache. So you can use just the user ID and get the device ID from a local cache, which is faster to do it. Now, if you have to manage the whole lifecycle on your own, it will be an overhead, a big overhead, because you have to make sure that whenever the instance starts, the data is there in the local cache, and whenever there is some update, you want to get those updates and put them as soon as possible in your local cache, and you want to do this for each instance. Right, how RedisAnt helps is that it takes the whole life cycle from your service and does it on your own. It connects with MongoDB, look for the updates which are coming in for those collections you want to sync, and then send those changes to your local cache. And whenever the service starts, RedisAnt makes sure the data is always there in local cache, so you don't have to worry about anything. Let's look at the technical diagram of how it works. The two main components, one is RedisAnt server and the other is RedisAnt client. Let's look at the RedisAnt server. How RedisAnt server works is it basically tails or reads the OP logs from MongoDB in real time, and whenever there's a change in that particular collection you're trying to sync, it sends those changes by RedisAnt Enterprise pops up, and well, that's all RedisAnt server is doing. It is basically listening to those changes real fast and in a smart way, so you don't have to say it is not sending any junk data, only the data which is in respect to that particular collection or database. Let's look at RedisAnt client. RedisAnt client have two functions. One is whenever the instance starts, we want to make sure that we ingest the complete documents from your Mongo collection and write them down in RedisJSON, so your service won't have to worry about doing so. The second task is listening to those changes which are coming in from RedisAnt server and put them down in your RedisJSON. Again, now your service won't have to do it on your own. So now the whole lifecycle is managed by these two services, and your service which you're trying to write can go on without worrying. Now, whenever you want a device ID for a particular user, you just have to use RedisJSON, which is in local cache, and get it done with it. Let's look at the code for this. Both these services are written in Golang, and they use a file, a config file, which I was talking about, which defines that which database, which device ID, and which user field we want to use as a key. So it makes it really simple for you to get started with local caching with zero overheads. This is the README file which you can go through. I will come to the demo part now. So this is my local environment. All the services are up and running. I also have a database where I'm using the same example of notification. I have two documents. One is for user ID 1, the other is for user ID 2. They have a device ID. I have in my local system, you can say local instance, my Redis is up and running. I will connect to the CLI, and let's just try getting the key 1. Which is a user key, right? Right now it's nil. There's nothing there. Now let's maybe try starting our service. I will use the make file to run the service. Now how the service works, it will read the config files. It will go to Mongo and fetch the data, start syncing it, and then listen to those changes. Now if we go and try to see the data is there, now you will see the data is there and the syncing has started working.